The big question is, will you ever come back to Days? Or if you were asked, would you come back? Or when are you returning? And I've been obviously getting that question since February of 2020, when we were released from the show to rest the characters. And that was kind of the big question that everyone's head is like, you know, well, when are you coming back? Is it a short time? Would you come back? Like, what's going on? And for me, I kind of started the process because it came out of left field initially.
Yeah. Yeah.
So in my mind, I had always thought that there'd be a conversation of like, hey, do you want to, you know, sign for another year? And this is probably going to be your last year, or we're going to rest your character, or that I would say it.
Right.
Where I would say, look, like, I want to let you know out of respect, like, I'm going to do one last year. So if there's any storyline or anything, I just want to give you a heads up in advance.
Yeah.
Rather than wait till 4 weeks before the contract and then say, never mind. But then for whatever reason, it happened so quickly. So it was kind of like, oh, you know, I kind of landed in the sense of like, well, what am I going to do here? Because this is probably temporary. Every character, even if the character dies, comes back at some point. So for the first 3 to 4 weeks, I was just kind of getting my bearings, and we were kind of deciding, well, what now? Because I'm pretty sure they're going to call back the characters at some point, call me back at some point. But, you know, waiting around is not healthy. But then 3 weeks later, the pandemic happened. So I was only really off the show for 3 to 4, maybe 5 weeks. I don't remember the timeline exactly, but then the whole world shut down. And then the question became, well, when is the industry coming back? Let alone when, if and when would the characters come back? And Alyssa and I, which I've shared many times, but if you're coming to the channel for the first time or just hearing this for the first time, if they would have offered me a contract and there was no pandemic and they offered me a contract in February of 2020, I would have said yes for one more year, and I would have let them know, like, hey, I'm going to do one more year, but this is going to be it for me. The reason I would have done just one more year was Alyssa and I wanted to get married. We are thinking about starting our family, and we wanted to be closer to our family, and being in Los Angeles and trying to be an actor forever. And being away from the family while raising a kid, we had that discussion for many years where we were just trying to find a way to, like, when was the perfect time to leave, like, and to go to Florida. So that was always the plan. It just so happened to be cut a little short in the sense that I wasn't given that extra year, and then the pandemic happened. But here we were in the summer of 2020, not knowing what was going to happen. Mm-hmm. And the being, you know, living in California at the expensive rate that it is awesome when you have the freedom to live your life,
right.
Which it seems like it's gotten way better, but then that's, you know, the whole thing. But just in general, to sit in an apartment paying almost $3,000 a month to be in lockdown was painful. Because that's the reason you pay those high expenses, is to work a industry job like acting, which pays well, and that whole thing. So we go, you know what? This is the time.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to preface this whole conversation with, by this time, we would have been to Florida and we would have started this next chapter, whether I would have done another year or not or whatever. This was kind of in our mind. We would have been here spring of 2021, but we happened to be here earlier. So when I was off the show in February and we were trying to figure everything out, even though the pandemic kind of clouded the idea of anyone's future because you didn't know what was going to go on, I was wrestling with the idea of, if they ever were to call, would I go back? And for 8 months, a year, actually, how long? Yeah, it's been, oh my God. For more than a year, I was being honest. Where people said, would you ever go back? My answer was kind of like, well, the door will always be open.
Right.
It's always open in Salem or, you know, whatever it may be, because that was honest. I had not fully checked out to the idea of going back if asked.
Mm-hmm.
But I would say around this past spring, I really started to have to make decisions of really letting that go in order to fully focus on moving forward in my life. And I kind of made that decision. So if you've noticed when following me, anytime I was asked anything about Days, because I didn't feel honest saying, well, the door's always open and giving false hope, I just kind of didn't answer the question. But I go live, I make content, we're on the podcast, there's so many things going on. that it's hard to dodge that question all the time. Mm-hmm. And I figured, you know, with this Q&A, it got asked like so much. So maybe I should speak to that. But a couple months ago, I did make the decision for ourselves, our futures and everything, that if days were ever to call, I know this is going to be disappointing to so many of you, but I would not go back. And that decision didn't come lightly, and it didn't come overnight. I genuinely thought about that because I knew with the soap opera world that a day probably would come.
Sure.
Not necessarily, but probably if you look at the statistics. So it wasn't a rarity where I go, oh, I'm done and this never happens. So I really put a lot of thought into it. And a few months ago, I really had to make that decision. We had a long conversation. I said, if they ever were to call, I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to go back. I need to focus on my future. And I think the problem that I was having was having one foot in the future and one foot in the past wasn't allowing me to give my 100% to my future. And I've used this analogy a million times, but it's that story of that war that took place on a beach.
Mm-hmm.
And the soldiers got off their boats and they were completely overwhelmed and outnumbered. And the general burned their ships so that they knew there was no retreat. And what that caused in those soldiers was, I don't have anywhere to go. I don't have my boat to get back on. I must fight to win and I have to forge forward. I have no other option. And I needed to make that decision for my future because always in the back of your head, if you take out the impact that the story made, the wonderful experiences and friends and all of that, and you look at it as a strict career, job, financial decision, it's not healthy to try to build something and take on these great ventures and challenges that we're taking on.
Yeah.
Within the back of your head going, well, I mean, if it doesn't work, I'm sure they'll call one day.
Right.
Like, I'm sure. That is unhealthy. That means my ships are still there. And I just finally gathered the courage to tell myself that if that day ever comes, I have to say no. I have to move forward because I just can't keep going back and forth. It's sending mixed signals, I feel, for my energy and for my future and to the universe that I'm like, I had to make the decision. So I kind of made that decision in my head. And then I started making decisions in our career and our opportunities and different things, just different because I go, this is it. I have to make this work. So,
and also too, just to quickly
speak please,
on
I
the end of that
more.
Is we tried in 2016 as well to have a residence in Florida and then also Los Angeles, and for him to go back and forth because I had to be in Florida for work at the time. And even trying to do that in like, what, it was like 4 weeks we tried it. It was just too much on both of us and we had to be separate. So us building a life here in Florida, and even for me, like now this is where my work is and I can't really just like, I mean, I can leave, but we're building a life here and then eventually when we have a family. And I think something like you having a job in California and going back and forth, that's going to be just so taxing on us as a family, just on your body, on everything. And then also with all the other work we're pursuing as well, it just takes that attention away from it. So there's so many different reasons. You know, he obviously beautifully stated how he was feeling about it. But, you know, from the significant other's perspective too, we don't really love being away from each other. That's a lot. It's a long way to travel and, you know, different time zones. And it just would be really, really tough if that were ever an option or if you're presented with that. So I think from my end too, it's just really helpful and nice to know that we're both, you know, in this together and we're not going to be living separate lives when we're starting, you know, a new life here in Florida. So just a little bit of my two cents, I guess.
Yeah. And it's also too, you know, it's a it's a difficult thing because there's really no one to go to for advice on this particular situation. Because I'm in a unique situation that when you're on television and you get a sense of micro fame, there's such an energy that is through everyone you meet, is through everyone on social media that knows you from the show, and or if you're introduced in real life, There's an energy that pulls you towards that character, that career, and you don't realize until you're on this end of it what a thousand voices on social media feels like. And I think even some of the big creators, we don't even know what a thousand like haters feels like.
Right.
When there's a like you know you can have a million followers or you can be the Rock, but even if you think of yourselves making any big life decision and there's a thousand people in an audience, let alone a half a million people, but a thousand people in an auditorium that's looking at you and you're on stage telling them something that's going to disappoint all 1,000 of them because they love you, they support you, you've made a difference in their life, and to stand up there and to have this conversation actually isn't that easy because I'm empathetic to how people feel. But at the same time, I have to rip the Band-Aid off eventually because I need to allow that to happen for people to accept that and or not to. But it's just very difficult. Like telling all my friends, telling my family, like truly making that decision, because I had a lot of friends and family that would ask me. And that's what's interesting is when you're in a profile job like that, people are really curious. So no matter who we meet or what we do, yeah. Every question is like, well, would you ever go back? Or what are you doing now? Like, I had an interesting job and I appreciate that. But you're getting asked it all the time. So you're always thinking about how would I answer this? What's the answer to that? And because the job is looked at as like unique or cool or different, you almost feel a little guilt or bad saying that you no longer want to pursue that.
But you also don't live there anymore. If you lived in California and you had this answer, that's a little different, you know. Different actors have different kind of, you know, careers they're pursuing. But I'm just saying it would be different if you were in that world.
Maybe not, though, because if I was still there and was like, hey, I decided not to move forward, I just want to do movies now, that would kind of be the same thing.
Sure, but still a little different. Like if you were actively pursuing a career, I feel like it would be harder to say no, maybe.
I don't know. We're not in that situation, so it's already such a heavy-weighted thing just in general.
Do you think in the future you'd ever want to act again?
I do, but not in the traditional sense. You know, now that could change, but the idea of ever putting auditions on tape, living in L.A. again, like, to me, that is done.
Mm-hmm.
Will we write and sell a film or act in short films or do something in TV, whether it's, you know, shorts or reality, right, or grow the social media channel to something where we can do big budget things on social, whether it's acting or hosting or something like that? I see that. But for me to get an audition, get into character and do that traditional thing, I just, deep down personally, which is even hard to say out loud, I've just lost interest in that. I think that I got to do more scenes than probably the top 5% of anyone who's ever acted.
Yep.
I have probably, Wally Kurtz said this to me once when we were talking. We have filmed more scenes that have been released to national television, to the public, than probably Robert De Niro or any of these famous actors. Like, they have not filmed as many scenes as we have. So I just feel like I went there, I had 500 auditions, I got that experience, I've played many different characters, and I got to grow with this character, Sonny, for 9 years, 800 some episodes, probably 4,000 or 5,000 scenes, memorizing, crying, laughing, love, fear, anger. And I just feel like I was able to, I went to LA, I accomplished something I'm so proud of that is extremely difficult to do.
Yeah.
I don't take it for granted, especially now that I'm older. I definitely don't take the Emmy for granted, considering how hard it has been for 5 years to even get a nom. So I have now, in retrospect, have a great appreciation for my work being recognized in that way. I will always be a Emmy winner. I will always be Sonny Kyriakis, who filmed 800 and some episodes on Days of Our Lives.
Yeah.
And I just feel I really accomplished something great. I met great people in Hollywood. I met my wife. I grew up as a person. I became so much more knowledgeable and wise. I went through trials and tribulations, through challenges. I had so many successes, so many failures, so many victories, and overall a ton of learning experiences. And I feel that now I'm in Florida, this is a complete fresh new start for me in career, in life, in geography, where I'm at. I was in Ohio till I was 18 years old. 3 weeks after high school, I moved to LA. So I never lived in Ohio as an adult. I never had to work, pay bills, and support myself in Ohio. I was just in high school, like living the dream as a kid would. And then I grew up for 15 years in Hollywood, and that's all I knew.
Yeah.
Every store, every person you meet was all in Hollywood. And I'm really enjoying exploring the world and exploring a new place where the heartbeat of the city is not acting, music, etc. It's a different vibe.
Yeah.
And I'm just excited to be in this pulse and just seeing a different way of life that doesn't revolve around Hollywood. And I'm thoroughly enjoying it. And it's just different. Like, you almost, when people say, do you miss California or do you like Florida better? It's kind of like a question that can't really be answered. It's right. Kind of like California is awesome and Florida is awesome. They each have their pros and cons, especially for the time of my life. Like, now, this is the time to be here in Florida, next to family, and this is where I'm at. So I look back at it, but to wrap up, even like some of the acting stuff too, I do think we'll do some sort of acting in the future.
Of course.
But I think it's going to be in a new way. I think it's going to be through YouTube and Facebook. I think it's going to be through us selling a script and acting in it or something like that. But the whole traditional way for me, that process, I no longer enjoy. And the entire point of life is to find something that you enjoy the process of.
Definitely.
On your way to hitting a goal. And living in LA, auditioning 2-3 times a week for different roles in the hopes of booking something big or a character that I love, I would not look forward to that process. So I had to come to terms with that. I'm kind of glad that I waited a year.
Yeah.
Because I was flushing all this out. We were also going through a pandemic, which everybody was like, everything kind of got, you know, twisted around. But I'm very, very in tune with my truths, with what I want, where I'm at. And I'm very aware of the work we did as an audience and as Sonny with Wilson and the storyline. That was a bonus. I understood there was going to be challenges,
yeah.
But I didn't realize it was going to be so impactful. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to look back at Days as a wonderful, wonderful experience in my life, a huge chapter. Every big life event in my 20s was also linked in with Days.
Yeah.
Many days in the makeup chair, the stories that the makeup artist knew, because you come in, you're like, so last night, or hey, this is going on in my life. And but that's how I kind of want to remember this. And that's what I know it's going to take people who are disappointed in this news. But I know that you'll also be able to kind of let that sink in of like appreciating, which I know you do, what we did. And I'm just trying to just like turn you away from the disappointment aspect of it.
And I think too, life is all about growth. It's all about progression. And us being in our 30s, we have seen what it's like having big dreams and goals in your 20s. And then, you know, some you accomplish, some you don't, but you're allowed to have new dreams, new visions. That's a sign that you're growing, that you're continuing to follow your heart, to do at the end of the day what makes you happy. Because in life, you just have to find whatever sets your soul on fire and do it. And that can change.
Yeah.
You know, that's showing that you're living life, that you're progressing, that you're going after it, that you're stepping out of your comfort zone. So I'm just really, really proud of you, because I know this has been a huge chapter in your life. And there are going to be so many other chapters and really cool things that you're going to be doing in life. And that was just a really cool, awesome thing to experience and for you to be able to have, you know, in your life.
Yeah.
It's so cool.
No, well, thank you. And I think that's what I learned about myself is how I'm built. I think whether it was days, whether it would have been a CW show, a movie series, if I would have gotten into, you know, public relations, I don't know what else I would have done.
Yeah.
I have found what makes me happy in life is the progression of starting at the bottom and working your way through the top of a challenge and learning experience is where my true happiness comes from. And I think as much, and I will tell you this, I am so grateful for the last year I had on Days, because if I would have gotten let go before the Will in jail and Adrian dying story, I feel I would have left some stuff on the table. I got to act and got to,
share your talent.
And that's out there forever. It is so hard to do that kind of acting. And I'm just like blown away that I was able to pull that off. But to like cry and to be emotional and to be angry and to be torn into all that kind of stuff. Like, I really feel like I gave my 100%. Mm-hmm. And I just feel if I went back, yes, we could tell more great stories. But I just feel like I literally gave my 100% and I accomplished what I set out to do there. Mm-hmm. And now I'm on to like something new. And for those of you who have been following us, you know I kind of jump around. I kind of go, oh, this is a good idea, or this is a good idea. But then we've stuck with things like podcasting for a long time, stuck with Days for a long time. There are things, but I always like tasting. And there's certain aspects of different projects we're working on now that are just getting me excited. And
hey, if you need your Freddie fix, come on in, sit down, have a cup of coffee, watch our podcast. We're here every Wednesday.
Well, that's the other bonus too. If this was 1992, I would have just been like a ghost.
Yeah.
But the cool thing is that there is social media, so you can keep up on us in our personal lives if that's what you like doing.
You've been blowing up to have on social media lately, babe. This is like a TikTok star I live with. My husband's a TikToker.
And I don't even dance. So, but yeah, so we're going to continue to evolve and continue to grow, and continue to keep you up to date with everything. Yep. But I couldn't continue to ignore these messages, and I couldn't in good heart, I couldn't in good faith, just blow off the question with, hey, maybe we'll be back one day, knowing that I've already mentally made the decision that I wouldn't.
Right.
And it took me a few months to figure out, well, when's the right time? To be able to break the news. And moving forward, I know every Days of Our Lives fan's not going to see this. So the question will probably come up a lot. And I'm going to do my best to maybe answer it every so often. But I actually feel better even saying, even though there's no live audience right now, I can like imagine people watching it. But it was hard. It was hard. Like every discussion, even when I told my parents, I was like, hey, you know, I just want, because my mom even asked me before. She's like, hey, if they ever called, would you go back? And I was always like, oh, I don't know. And then I remember just telling her one day, I was like, you know, when she asked me, I was like, I actually wouldn't. I actually wouldn't. And like just telling everybody, because even my parents think it's awesome. Like their son's on a national television show. And they're like, this is like so, you know. But to me too, it's always weird because I never felt any different. Like to me, it was always just like a really cool job.
Sure.
But I never let it like get to me in like a Hollywood way. So to me, I was just like, my alarm goes off. I go to work. You say hi to people. You're polite. You're professional. You do your job. You go home. But I'm aware that it made an impact. I'm aware that family and friends and all the fans around the world really thought it was awesome and really enjoyed it.
Beautiful.
And
story.
I just want to just thank you. And I'm sorry if you're a little sad. But I just had to be honest and truthful, and that's what we do here on the podcast. And I'm glad I have a platform where I had the ability to actually talk this out, because yet again, just in a tweet, I don't know if you can create the emotional journey.
Well, I'm proud of you for opening your heart and speaking your truths. Love you so much.
And that's all we can do these days, you know, is... just be authentic and open, and I feel like I just tried to be as honest as possible. So so I just thank you for everything, and I just wanted to kick it off by answering that question.